I clearly know that Russell is running around talking to everyone and telling everyone the same thing.
I don't trust Russell's ass at all. At all. I mean, he's running around with puppy dog eyes over poverty since the minute we landed here. He won't do anything without her. He has to sleep next to her every night.
For him to be following around poverty is no strategy at all. It's puppy love.
I don't trust anyone. And I actually do trust him, even though he's kind of a lunatic.
Crazy Russ, who I keep forgetting is around because he just lives in the woods. And he's like, comes like sneaking out with like a bag full of crabs.
Russell's sort of getting the like, you know, beta dog syndrome where he's really pissed that Rob's sort of like the alpha male, but Russell never wants to say a word. He seems almost happy when people fail. Like we were trying to fish and he's like, how many fish you get? How many fish you get? We're like, we're trying, dude. How many fish did you get sitting at camp looking in your dirty socks, flirting with poverty? How many fish did you get there? None? Oh, cool. Thanks.
The question is he really going for a walk or is he going looking for the idol?
I need him to be down the beach because if he is, he's... He's a stupid ass. Russell feels his own face.
I mean, it sucks, but that's what we said, right?
He's okay. Done. I don't care if he has it or not.
Russell's a bonehead. He's like the Hobbit on crack.
Russell, if you don't have it and you didn't find it, you best look for it. Point blank.
Who's left up there? With Harvey?
Whatever his name is.
We're gonna look real dumb if he's out here playing us all.
Russell's gonna find out soon enough that he's out of his league.
You need to get in the ocean and wash your ass. I can't stand you and I can't wait for you to go home. Adios.
Anybody that gives away immunity and leaves himself blank, it's like a suicide bomber. You can't stop someone like that. If they don't care about their own fate in the game, that's a wild card. They'll do anything.
It's no secret that Russell has a little boy crush on Parvati because he's, I mean, let's face it, he's like a bandy-legged little troll who, you know, sort of like scampers around with his tooth missing and, you know, is in and out of the bushes and never washes. And she pays attention to him and she has like no problem flirting with clearly anything that walks.
What do you suggest?
One of these.
One of who?
Right here. What you want me to say?
I don't know.
You want me to be,
That's not a way to gather friends, I don't think.
Well, you know.
How do you two feel about that?
I don't like it.
Oh no, I think he's right.
What kind of logic is that, Russell? That's a new one.
Motivated by jealousy, Russell used his power of persuasion and gathered enough votes to eliminate his adversary.
Rob.
Coach, Courtney, and Sandra refused to vote for Rob, and now they're trapped in a tribe controlled by Russell, whose ego may have just put the villains in a hole they can't get out of.
Ridiculous that they're cowards and they want to vote out Boss and Rob because Russell is a bully. No more, no less. He's a bully.
It's based on Russell's idea of what he wants his survivor to be like, and everyone's going along with it out of like fear or something.
Sucks.
Russell is the most crazy, paranoid person on the planet who took offense at every single man on the team. So we had sort of like clash of the testicles, as it were, on the villains camp.
He's digging his own grave just like Rob did.
I told Russell that Coach was talking about voting for him. And Russell's so stupid, he ate that crap up. I'm telling you, he's like, oh my God, I can't trust him. And the sooner he goes, the better. So Russell, he don't know how to play this game. Yeah, he's done good so far, but with me, he don't know what he got himself into.
It's stupid to let him go. I just told you,
I don't agree with it.
You're not listening to me.
I'm gonna talk to you.
I think it's really stupid to get rid of another strong player. I threw that out there and Russell freaked out and screamed at me because he's just so in control of this game and everything has to go the way he wants it to go.
I might have a change of heart. I think Danielle might be right.
It's absurd. First, Russell wants to vote off Coach, and then all of a sudden he wants to vote Courtney. Jeez, this tribe cannot get its act together. That's a problem. You know, we can't make a decision as a cohesive unit to save our lives. We'll fill Russell in on a need-to-know basis. And right now, Russell doesn't need to know. So he's not gonna know. I'm not gonna tell Russell about the idol right now. I want Russell to be out of the loop for a little bit. I don't see anything wrong in making him wait. I really don't. Doesn't mean I don't trust him. It's just, I kinda wanna see him squirm a little bit. It's fun. It's not all Russell running the show around here. He's not the king of Survivor. I'm the queen. And usually the king does what the queen says anyways, so I'm cool.
You have faith in Russell. Don't trust him. He's on the villain side for a reason.
Russell just gave me his immunity idol. So that makes me safe for tonight. And I have my own immunity idol.
I hope Harmony plays that idol and shows everybody that Russell is a liar.
That little troll plays a liar. That's for you.
Get out of here, for real.
Jerry, that one's for you too.
Damn it.
Russell likes to be in control because he thinks he's the godfather of this game. And I think having me have an idol that he didn't know about made him feel like he wasn't in control and scared a little bit. But that's kind of what I wanted anyways.
I need to get Russell out.
Russell, you want Russell gone?
Yeah.
Russell's gone.
All four
he's
of
done.
Us are going.
We could get Russell out of this game. The guy is a piece of garbage.
You know what, Jeff? For some reason, I think somebody has flipped. And to keep them all honest, I hope I'm doing the right thing and playing it for myself this time.
Parvati. Two votes Amanda, one vote Parvati. A frightened Russell played the hidden immunity idol.
Russell's super paranoid, and that is going to be his downfall.
Russell wasted his idol.
I think Russell is a deceitful person, and anything he says is a lie. My only hope is to show the villains that disgusting side and ask them truly, do they want to be involved in that?
You've already proven yourself to be a disgusting, terrible human being to swear on your kid's life.
He found it. I see it in his pocket.
Russell swears that Rupert found the idol.
Of course I know that's a lie because I have the freaking immunity idol.
And go ahead. Do what you think you need to do, Poverty.
Don't yell at me, Russell.
I can't believe you. You're thinking like this.
Thinking like what? Like I want to have a conversation with
you
someone?
Can't.
Russell comes out of nowhere and says, they're blindsiding you. That's what's happening. I'm like, I'm not voting Danielle tonight. I don't care what you say. I'm not doing it.
It's only one thing that has to happen today, and that's Danielle go home.
Really? Really?
I got another plan. Danielle.
Yeah, Russell's wearing the immunity necklace, and he's the most nervous guy on the beach. I finally figured it out. The guy really is the devil. That's why he always wears the fedora or the buff over his head. There's a pair of horns hiding under there. I know there are.
How did this get flipped on me?
It's crazy.
Why,
like,
why
we
would
all...
you want to keep Colby and Rupert around? That
it doesn't
make
sense.
Any sense.
It does not make sense.
Russell running around double talking is hurting his game. He's getting outplayed by me and Danielle at this point. And it's making him a little bit crazy.
I don't understand how she's just putting it all on me while I'm trying to mess with it when she agreed totally.
What is he thinking?
I don't know.
Those two guys made it to me and Jerry, they're winning.
I think Russell was jealous of my relationship with Danielle, and he wanted to make sure that it was him and I that were the closest to.
Here he comes.
The move that Russell made tonight has made me completely distrust him.
One more survivor.
Sandra!
Sandra and Fernando joining Parvati and Michael and Jerry and Jennifer.
It's good to see you.
Russell got his little feelings hurt because he didn't get invited to go on the reward.
I hate Russell. I want Russell out so bad I could taste it. But them girls won't go. Everybody wants to go with Russell to the end because he's so bad that they'll win against him. That's why he's still here.
Are you with me or are you against me?
I'm against you, Russell. Well, Was that what I said?
That's exactly
she
what you said.
I'm against you.
She said she's against me. So that was the last of that conversation.
Who invited Boston Rob back to the party? Are you with me or are you against me?
He's the one in the book.
Parvati was like, don't worry, Sandra, because I'm not writing your name down and neither is Jerry. So Rupert is going to go home even if Russell is upset.
He thinks he's writing everything down. Mm-hmm.
If anybody has the hidden immunity idol.
Should I let you finish?
How is that a good strategic play?
You use an idol to save yourself when you didn't.
Right, and it was a bad play for me.
You straight up lied to me about it.
What do you mean? Like, when I find an idol, I should hurry up and tell you? How come the minute Sandra gets an idol, I gotta go tell Russell? He wants to micromanage the whole tribe, and unfortunately, I'm not the kind of person you can micromanage. Sorry.
I didn't know about it, okay? Just leave it at that. Done and done. I didn't know about it.
All right, done and done.
Okay. Get over yourself for 1 second. Ridiculous. I could care less if Russell's running around stomping his feet like a little 2-year-old child who got his toy taken away, because that's pretty much what he's acting like, and it makes him look like a fool.
Burning bridges along the way eventually cost him the $1 million.
The winner of Survivor Samoa.
This season, more of the same. Bullying.
You ain't making any sense.
You're not listening to me.
If you do that, you're out this game. I promise you.
And making deals with everyone in sight.
I want to take y'all to the top three, man. I want to trust you all the way to the final three.
Will his aggressive approach finally pay off?
I want you in the final three because I think I could meet you for the million.
All right.
Straight up.
I'll take the 100,000. You know how I feel.
It just makes sense to me.
Russell's keeping me around because I'll never get a single vote. But I don't know about that.
If Sandra's with us, she instantly gets Amanda, Candace, and Courtney.
I don't think so.
Best option for me is to take Jerry and Sandra. That would be the best strategic move for me.
Your best strategic move?
Would be Jerry and Sandra.
No, because Sandra would win.
Tell me the truth. If I would have been on jury, would you have voted for me?
I told you I would have voted for Sandra.
I would have voted for you. If you would have put me on the jury, I still would have voted for you.
That's nice of you.
But you wouldn't have voted for me, really?
I would have voted for Sandra.
No, seriously?
I told you.
Wow.
It's so funny. We're gonna lay this bomb on him tonight. He don't know what it's like to be up against two chicks. Bam! Ruthless, my God.
I'm gonna burn his hat.
Oh my God.
So he can take his bald-headed ass to the hand drama council.
Are you gonna tell?
Are you kidding?
That's how much game I got.
Russell is obnoxious. So I took his hat and I threw it in the fire. I don't care.
Russell, did you really just say there wasn't any luck involved in getting you here?
I do believe that I got here without any luck. I believe I got here with my strategic play.
Okay, well, I was just double checking because you are delusional.
You can be a very little man in stature and also in word.
You've told dirty lies, lies that you didn't need to tell, and you hurt people doing that.
If you think you should be proud of how you got here, you're sadly mistaken.
It's clear that there's been a lack of skill in your jury management. That being said, with what you've heard from all of these people thus far, would you change anything about your game now?
You know, I don't regret anything that I played. Because if I don't play like that, there's no way I'd be here. If that's what you want me to say, I'm not going to say that.
Would you change anything?
I'm not going to sit here and tell you what you want to hear. I'm going to tell you what the truth.
But after hearing what all of these people have said and how you're not going to get any votes. Nobody respects the way that you played the game, Russell.
Russell, are you surprised you didn't win? Didn't get a vote?
You know what? I didn't play twice. I played once.
Are you aware during the game, like when you get into an argument with Rupert that's that vicious, we just saw a clip of it coming in, you're not going to get his vote. When you betray Jerry, probably not going to get her. Are you thinking, do you think, well, that's 2 votes, but I've got others?
You know what? After I played the first time and played right again, I played one time. And I was whipped.
That's not the question.
I do what I can do, and you know what? I make it to the end every time.
Boston Rob.
Boston Rock.
He doesn't play the game to win. And it's clear in his strategy. He plays a good game to get to the end, but he doesn't play a game to win the game. And that's where he and I differ, among other things as well.